Where last we left, the sweet Crimson Bones. Very pleased to have you gentlemen here again. Minus Skeezel Binbag for now. Unfortunately. But it is what it is.
It is.
What happened on the last episode? Let's see. After finishing the celebrations of the Great Tree, the Crimson Bones, eager to exchange their goods and valuables for more primo adventuring gear, have ventured, thanks to the power of Lokir Bitterroot, to the trade capital that is Atwa. Well, trade capital of Atwa, that is the bustling city of Garza. After bidding their comrades farewell, the Crimson Bones set off toward Garza, hundreds of miles per hour, racing wildly along the wilds and the Golden Way, being almost struck by a strange foe en route, and meeting an odd wizard who tested the city of Garza's shield of anti-magic and was promptly arrested for it. Crimson Bones, using this distraction, slipped in past the city gates, seemingly unnoticed. The party bartered and sold and bought wares, with plenty of more adventures to be had in the bustling urban center. This is where we rejoin our heroes now, within the heart of the Market Bazaar district of Garza. After doing some light shopping, the party has reconvened back together in a small little courtyard, the sun being high in the sky still. You gentlemen are pretty much left to your own devices, just about. You are in the, you know, a beautiful little square area of Garza, surrounded by, you know, bustling townsfolk, still in the bazaar district, as it were. Let's get over there now.
Ooh.
The market, aka the market district. One and the same. I'll have to clarify that later. It is you, Syphax, Skeezel Binbag, and Uzgu Bonebreaker, Mandy and Gelden, and top of the order is whatever you two gentlemen have in mind. You can see, you spot Uzgu Bonebreaker that Syphax has, some treats or something perhaps that he's purchased, or, you know, something to that effect. He's like, you know, it's like, keeping kind of like sheltered to himself. And that seems to have his attention.
What you got there, buddy?
Oh, check it out, Uzgul. And Syphax uncups his hands, Uzgul Bonebreaker, and shows you a small, kind of like almost like bird cage of some caliber. And it containing a small insect. It looks like a cricket of some kind. Oh, isn't he cute?
What is it?
It's a cricket in a cage, they said. I think it's pretty neat. Cricket in a cage. And the cricket's like,
is it gonna help with your songs or something?
Oh man, that's a good. I didn't think about that. That's a good idea.
An interesting man, Syphax.
Oh, hey, what can I say? It's about time. About time I treat myself.
Mandian interrupts and he asks if his cricket can help lead us to the city square. We can see what sort of see if there's any postings or anything interesting going on.
Ooh, wow.
I mean, you know the way around here, right, Syphax? You've been here before.
Well, kind of, sort of. I bet if we just head back toward the main road and follow it up, we'll hit the main square eventually. Come on, let's go. Okay. And Syphax ushers you all along with his puts his puts his cricket over on his belt, and you gentlemen start heading off down the way when, rather suddenly, there is a disturbance of some kind. You hear, well, let's get perception checks, Crimson Bones, as something's occurring before your very ears.
I'll hit my passive.
Oh, it's passive time. What is your passive, Wuzgo Bonebreaker?
15.
15. 15. 15 and 16. Wuzgo and Mandy, and you both make out what seems to be the shrieks of nearby townsfolk. The crowd is starting to become alarmed around you, as a matter of fact. A wave, you know, of panic is growing through the crowd, and everyone is fleeing, pushing past one another, and, you know, and eventually it turns into a chaos and a bit of a scramble here, just over in the manner of a few seconds, Crimson Bones. What's everyone up to? Anything in particular?
Where are we in relation to this? Like, how far do we seem to be?
Ooh, let's see. I would say, my sweet little Crimson Bones, you'd probably be about here. I intended to get the marker from the party map. I should do that.
Yeah, we're about there, you say?
I should do that. Hold on. Hold on a second.
Like here, you say? There?
Relax. Settle down.
You're there, everywhere, what?
Boom.
Okay.
Nice.
Boom, nice.
We're about there, and we hear commotion coming from where?
Basic.
Toward the square?
Not far away from you guys at all. It is some type of nearby disturbance. Who's a good bone breaker? You look over yonder and see probably about 70 feet or so away, along some of like the nearby stalls and so on that you and Syphax were traipsing through in search of treats, there is a creature of some kind that has like emerged up on top of these crates. It's black and white, almost like skunk shaped. Uzu Bonebreaker, you may be familiar with this creature. Why don't you give me either a nature check or a history check with advantage to determine if that's the case? Ooh, indeed. What appears to be before you, I guess I'll describe it for you, Mandy and Gelden, as it was with Bonebreaker, you know what it is. It is a kind of almost like Wolverine statured-esque creature, black and white like a skunk, with these rather large legs and paws that are very, sort of reminiscent of a bear, really, a stouter creature. And it seems to be a bit more on the larger side. Who's a Bonebreaker? It's a badger. And not just any type of badger, it seems like a rather large badger at that. And with what this God? Crimson Bones, it's time for some fucking... For a little combat initiative action.
All right.
Here in the field, now, Uzgur Bonebreaker and Mandy Gelden, you're noticing off over yonder, it seems like a man is, you know, kind of like backing away as this badger beast is slinking and swelling, cornering this man, and a Mandy, and you spot out of the right corner of your eye, as well as you, Uzgur, a young girl, who is trying to get away from another one of these badger beasts, but it seems like the creature is gaining on the poor child. And when you are ready, Crimson Bones, you find yourselves up in the top of the courtyard. I'm sure ready to do something, even if it's just run away. It remains to be seen.
Badger attack.
A badger attack. You hear over yonder, Manny Gelden, from this guy over yonder. He's like, oh, my prized badger collection has escaped! help, help! and it seems like these badgers have escaped from one of these exotic, you know, animal traders. And it's going downtown. Let me see. What can I do here? Oh, I'll just call it round.
Now, I know this guy said there is prized badgers, but I mean, are they seeming hostile here? They like attacking this little kid?
It seems to be so, Uzgoob Bonebreaker. I mean, it could very well be the case that these creatures are like playfully trying to like, you know, like play, perhaps, you know, like maybe, perhaps, you know, perhaps one could interpret it that way. But at the same time, even if it is exhibiting playful behavior, which you doubt, it could very well be a fatal thing with a creature this size and a child that small. Seems very much to you like a dangerous situation. Let's see. I'll be piloting Syphax and the mighty Skeezwell bin bag.
Very good. I mean, I suppose.
Syphax like, ah, what the heck's going on? And I don't know. We'll see. We'll see how he does. on his fucking initiative.
Oh, he does great.
He knows exactly what's going on.
These damn badgers, Syphax.
Oh, damn. Syphax and Skeezwell.
Oh.
Oh, man. They're up there.
Two ties. That's funny.
Damn. I honestly can't believe it.
That's pretty funny.
I honestly can't believe it. Okay, let's see. We have there's like this farmer man, but he's just cowering, it seems, by his cart in fear of this badger onslaught that is coming. And I do have, let's see, the child will roll for the poor child's initiative. Yep, as I suspected, not very good. Not very good. Could be better, could be worse. Ooh, and now, of course, the piece de resistance. We've got some serious badger action. Crimson Bones beset by badgers. Or at least
badgers in the bazaar.
That's the name of the episode right there.
Yep, title it.
that's a good one. We've got at least one, two, three, four, count them, four badgers. Most of the people vacating, there are still a few civilians left behind. I would say, shit. I mean, the badgers pretty dexterous, but not as, I wouldn't say more dexterous than Manny Gelden or Rusko Bonebreaker. I would say that's unreasonable. Damn, the badgers will not have the upper hand, God willing. Syphax, the first act, he's like, oh, I'll save you, mister! And he makes a break for this man. His small wooden shield drawn, as well as his short sword. Syphax closes the distance, only finding that he just doesn't have the ability to get in range. Oh, poor Syphax. Poor Syphax. Let's see.
Poor Syphax. What's new, though?
Syphax, seeing that he's pretty much at the end of his rope, tucks his sword underneath his armpit, holding it there, and forces up the palm of his hand. He's like, ha! Time to show you guys this new power! Look, your Bitterroot showed me! And you watch as there's like this light blue kind of sphere that begins to form in the palm of Syphax's hand as he reaches out and unleashes it toward this badger. Syphax Blast! Syphax unleashes the Syphax Blast and it whizzes past the badger, popping against the ground. But it seems like it was a pretty nasty, little powerful beam of energy. Syphax's like, damn! Next one! And Skeezle Binbag is up next. Oh, Sawfax, get back here. You're not done making us money yet. And Skeezle Binbag will attempt to do something. I mean, I don't know. Would he cast Fireball? Probably not. Normally. No, you know, don't get me wrong. Normally he would, but
I smell more of a Chaos Bolt.
I mean, yeah. I mean, in the city, I don't know.
He's the one burn his gold down.
I'm gonna give him the benefit of the doubt on that one. And I think a Chaos Bolt is just what the doctor ordered. Perhaps upon that badger there. Oh, it does have a range of 120 feet. Shit. Chaos Bolt is fucking crazy. Yeah, it's gonna be a Chaos Bolt. At which one? Probably that one up on those boxes way over there. Nice fat open target. A 15 to strike. Is that even how this works? Yes. Yeah, it's a 15 to hit. Fucking that just strikes the beast. It just succumbs, taking a fucking nasty 17 damage. You watch Mandian and Uzgu Bonebreaker as Skeezle Binbag kind of like takes a knee behind a stall, looks over yonder, spots the badger, steps out like peeking behind for cover and does like a Kamehameha blast. And it's a terrible force of arcane energy. What is it, pray tell? Let's see. Four and seven. So it could be force damage or psychic damage. He's gonna go for the psychic damage. And it's just like a horrible, almost like hazy ray that just like flashes over at the speed of light, engulfing the poor badger. And the creature is definitely affected by it, but it seems like it shrugs it off, relatively speaking, and is ready for more. Mandy and Geld, you are up. There are 1, 2, 3, 4 badgers. This child and this man who Syphax used to be running to the aid of are in jeopardy. But other than that, that's all you really know.
Alright, hold on a sec. I need to move down to save this poor human.
Damn. Bandy and Hero Geld passing by this that disheveled like farmer sitting by hiding underneath his little mine cart.
You can go that far. Okay.
You're quick to press by, pushing up beside this, pretty short to the ground prancing beast, probably about 5 feet tall at the height of the back. A nasty, almost kind of like ferret head, with pretty sharp-looking teeth and big claws like that of a bear. What do you got for it, Mandy and Gelden?
I was thinking I was gonna lightning lure it, but I'm just out of range. It's 15 feet.
Damn. Shick.
I guess I'm gonna just firebolt it.
All right. When in doubt, firebolt.
A straight firebolt.
All right. It can be what? Well, 20 damage, potentially?
Up to 20 damage, yeah.
All means. Oh, damn. Just,
I can't believe it.
Just striking the beast. Just when you need a nice pop from your baseball-sized firebolt impacting the side of the black and white colored beast. Very, very reminiscent of that of a skunk. But with a small, stubby tail, which you have greatly singed for a whopping 14 fire damage. Well done, Manny Gelden. Anything else? The creature still stands.
Excellent. That'll have to be my turn.
Okay, very good. Very good. Well, it's good. Bonebreaker. Here you are in the fray. A bit on the back foot. It is finally your time for action. What do you desire to do?
Well, it's good. We'll step up 40 feet. It was that one, correct?
I'm sorry, which one, sir?
I'm pretty sure it's this one. 40 feet.
You got so much movement to play with. It's less of a concern.
I think it was even one more up. But you know what? I'll just attack this one in front of me.
So be it.
I will enter a rage, and ooh, using my newfound instinctive pounce, I will jump on this badger.
Ooh, okay, all right.
And attack it with my great root club.
Give me an acrobatics check, just for the fun of it. Just for the fun of it. Could even be with advantage, I think, but no need. It's looking good.
I was
going to
ask for it because I want a reckless attack, but I won't need it for that.
You can unleash everything you've got on this badger if you so choose, Uzgwood Bonebreaker.
Yeah.
Whatever you desire.
I jump on this bitch and hit it with my Great Root Club recklessly, of course.
Ooh. Just striking. You can add on
What did I roll for the extra that I forgot to toggle?
Let's see, I guess it'd be
3d2.
Yeah, yep, 3d2. You slash R 3d2. Oh, you might need like a slash R space 3d2. I think.
Extra.
Oh. Very good. So be it. A beautiful strike. 12 damage total dealt to the beast. Let's see, that use it at 40 something or other. Nice, beautiful. A nice snub against the creature, but it still stands. You've definitely gained its attention.
Kia.
Another strike unleashed recklessly. Your rage active in full. A beautiful strike. A whopping 21 blaster damage. The creature is heavily wounded by a shoulder strike from your large, great, like, piece of wood that you are swinging aptly and deftly upon this feral beast. He still stands. Anything else, Master Bonebreaker?
Well, this guy just notes how the great club feels in his hands, and he likes it.
Very good. Very good. Let's see, we've got a badger, Mandy Gelden. This badger that you have fired upon your fireball is distracted by you and closes the distance. Seemingly for now, you've saved the life of this small girl.
Thank God.
Well done, man. Well done. The badger will attempt to open up at you, of course, with its multi-attack, making up to 3 attacks. First things first, it'll make a bite attack. Munch. It munches on you for 12 piercing damage. His first attack.
-3 for 9.
-3 for 9.
My temporary hit points. Three damage. All right.
Boom. Boom. Just as such. And it will try to hit you with 1 claw attack. It hits you with a claw attack. 13 slashing damage. Just gives you fucking, like, this creature, you're like, oh, well, you know, this thing. It is very big, you know, so perhaps, you know, you may have lowered your guard initially. And then this thing just, like, gets up on its hind legs as it kind of like lunges up on you, and before long it has like these huge like dagger-like claws that are just digging into the frame of your armor, scraping away at you just like terribly. Devastating. And let's see, with another 13 slashing damage from that, that will do it for this giant badger's turn. Yeah, sizing you up. More to come. Uzgut Bonebreaker, the giant badger aside, you will be eager for revenge. It'll have advantage on the attacks, right? Because if you're a reckless attack.
Oh yeah.
Okay, so be it. Just so be it. So be it. It will unleash as well with its multi-attack. Going in for a nice, nasty little bite. 19 to strike. I believe it lands. 18 piercing damage, halved thanks to your sick rage. Incoming, another claw attack with advantage. Ooh, 27 to strike. That's a mean one. Not as much though. Only 13 slashing damage. We'll call it like six.
Seven. I'll
six,
round up.
Six, seven. What, you know? You know, whatever. Works for me. Good. Another juicy badger turn. The child flees. The child flees into the safety of perhaps their mother. Well done, Mandy and Gil.
Get out of here.
And the two.
Get into your mother.
You watch as the large, you know, woman, you know, grabs hold of the, you know, the small child, and there's a moment of grace, and you know, she looks up in your direction, and perhaps you hear a word of thanks that's hard to make out over like the slobbering of this creature like scratching into the frame of your suit, you know, the battle that's happening now. But all seems to be well in that regard. And they leave the frame of play. I will keep the child, however, in the turn order to act as like a civilian turn marker.
Sure.
Because this man's like, thanks! And hides behind these barrels. Like, watch out for those badges, they're nasty! And before long, it's time for some more badger action. This wounded fucking badger, as he's been back blasted, is like in a daze and like kind of like jumps half ass, like, you know, trying to do something. Landing in like these bags of fish, and like the bags of fish like spill over and like bust all over the ground and shit. And Skeezle Binbag calls it out. It's like, oh, there's another badger in those bag fishes. And it's true. Another badger has been unveiled from the bag of fish.
No.
And the bag of fish, unfortunately, is spilled all over the ground. It makes a huge mess. There's fish everywhere. There is a badger playing in these fish. And now it's here. Now it's here for everyone to have to deal with. And this badger makes its way up to you, Uzgut Bonebreaker. Seeing that it's giving one of its comrades a rough time, it will attempt to give you the business with a chomp attack. Chomping you for a nice little 13 piercing damage, fucking rounded to 7 if you desire.
Yeah.
All in all, and we've got one more badger. This badger is gonna make an intelligence check. Not with advantage. 8. Not intelligent enough right this moment. It's gonna skulk. It's gonna skulk around on the fringe, greeting its comrade. And preparing for the next round of badger conflict. This badger will be added to the turn order now. Syphax first up. Oh, what are these badgers doing here? Syphax rushes up to the aid of Uzgut Bonebreaker. Say, I got you, Uzgut Bonebreaker! For the Crimson Bones! Syphax cries out. And he busts down a Bardic Inspiration for you, Uzgut Bonebreaker. Singing a little singing a little limerick for you. And let's see, what else we got? Interesting. Okay. Syphax will then just try to take a nice meaty stab at this badger. And unfortunately he whiffs as the creature is kind of like just flailing about a flurry of claws in this melee. And Syphax also has to be wary of Uzgut Bonebreaker swinging around the great club of Wilkir Bitterroot. It is another serious obstacle. But thanks to Syphax's training, he can make a second attack. Unfortunately, it is also whiffed.
Damn.
And Uzgut Bonebreaker gaining a Bardic Inspiration. Nice blue. That'll be it for Syphax's turn. Innate, you know, doing what he can. Skeez will bin bag, spending a precious spell slot. Oh, what will he do now? Let's see, he thinks it's time for a little bit of magic missile. Ooh, right, and of course that reminds me. I almost forgot, of course, about the shield of anti-magic. How could I? That would have been a close one.
I can't believe
you. That sure would have been a close one. Oof. Cecil Binbag will attempt to cast magic missile. We'll see how he does. Let's see. Before I continue any further. Oof. That's rough. Cecil Binbag's like, ah, I gotta stop this. And he crutches out and fires like one singular magic missile that flies over and catches one of these badgers. But then he has like, what's this? And Skeez Whoopin' Bag is unable to continue with his spell casting procedure.
Damn.
Unfortunately, the effect of the Dram Ward suppressing his magical ability in this moment of great need. Not very good. Mandy and Gelden, you are up with Uzgut Bonebreaker next on deck.
Very good.
The badgers are here.
Mandy and Gelden is gonna punch this badger with his thunder gauntlets.
So be it. Oof. Yeah. Oof, that strikes. A meaty strike for 8 thunder damage off the cuff. The creature remains standing.
There's a quick follow-up with a second thunder gauntlet punch. Oh.
Ooh, nice. Very good. Very nice, Mandy and Gelden. How do you crit this creature? You may describe this last impactful blow is especially dank.
It uppercuts this badger's jaw, knocking its bottom row of teeth off of its face before it crumples to the ground.
A deafening strike. The badger's bite attack is no more.
Very good.
As a result of its crippling wound. Well done. Ooh. Well done, Master Gelden. Well done.
Thank you. And I think I want to take a bonus action, which I think I can still do.
Yes. Go
my
on.
Temporary hit points. My temporary hit points.
Oh, you're your whatever field.
Defensive field, yes.
Yeah. I think that is a bonus action too.
Believe so. Defensive field as a bonus action. I'm going to gain to 7 temporary hit points.
You might as well. You might as well. Very good. Very good.
That'll
is
be
right.
My turn.
Very good is right.
It is very good.
Ah, a fine showing, Master Gelden. Master Bonebreaker, you are up at display at this time in a sweet, juicy rage, surrounded by giant badgers.
This person standing behind these barrels behind me is that same person that called out like my badgers, right?
Yeah, that's him.
Looks good with a filthy, disgusting look on his face, looks over at him and says, get control of your badgers before I need to kill more. And I take another reckless. And I will even add Wrath Hue Blow at this creature.
Damn.
Ooh. I mean, I guess I'll describe it from like Syphax's point of view. Because Even if you miss, it'll still be sick. Syphax watches in horror as like Uzgut Bonebreaker like cocks back his body and it goes for like a big, huge two-handed swing with this big wooden twisted great club the size of like a child. And then like Uzgut Bonebreaker cocks back a little bit more, and up to almost like the ultimate length. And drawing back his hands as far down on the hilt of this great club as he possibly can, he goes for like an ultimate windup. Syphax like barely ducks it in time as it comes careening toward this badger. Which badger do you want to strike, Uzgut Bonebreaker, as you just hit the badger that you were going for?
This one on the left, the already injured one.
Very good, very good. So be it, so be it. It deals a disgusting, 21 damage? Phew.
19,
excuse me. LOL. Pretty close. And the badger, after this deafening strike, is still left standing.
I just want to make sure I'm doing this right. The Wrath use only one attack, correct?
Correct. Indeed. Right. Indeed.
I'll toggle that back off. And I will go for another attack. This thing needs to die.
One strike, you take the momentum gliding off the rise to come back for yet another. Ooh, are you striking with... Oh yeah, yep, you are striking with advantage because of the reckless attack, of course. Excellent. Because this badger is destroyed, ravaged by the force of your great club. Finally, the first badger to be felled in the field of battle. Well done. Well done.
Well done.
Anything furthermore, Master Bonebreaker?
Bullsker just looks at this next badger with pleasure. Anticipates his next attack.
Okay, excellent. Very good. Let's see, we've got the badger down by Mandy and Geldon. Let's see, Mandy and Geldon, this creature doesn't have a disadvantage against you, right? Just creatures other than you?
Correct.
Okay, very good. But it is missing. You see like its lower jaw is just like, it's like on, you know, basically like free flapping, unhinged from its skull. So it will only be able to make two claw attacks against you. No matter what. Do how it went this time around. It is pissed off though, and will try to mangle you with its claws. 21 to attack you with 12 slashing damage coming your way.
Okay, so it's 9 minus 7, so really 2. Okay.
Nice. A mere 2 makes its way actually to your person, and another nasty claw strike coming in. Oh yeah, they are just going for the soft points in the arm. They're kind of like getting up, like climbing on you, and then like almost kind of like koala, you know, like koala, like, you know, just like climbing upon you, you know, like grinding on you like a scratching post essentially, as you suffer another 13 slashing damage. Pretty mean, pretty nasty. You don't know how much more of this badger action you're going to be able to take, Mandy and Geldon. If it continues like this, who knows what's going to happen. Let's see, and we've got... we've got the civilians. The civilians are safe for now. Safe in the company of the Crimson Bones. Let's see, this badger... This badger is going to try to make an intelligence check. Nope.
You said no.
Nope. not this time. It did like see Syphax trying to take swings out of the corner of its eyes though, and it was displeased by that. So it's going to take a little slash attack against Syphax. Ooh, fucking Syphax up really bad. Immediately.
Oh.
That's that. That's a shit ton of damage. 13 damage to poor fucking Syphax. Um, He's just gonna have to take that one on the chin. Oh man, brutal. Okay. Well, taking one slash at Syphax like recoils in horror. He's like, ah! And like completely just sliced up by that badger. Then the badger turns its attention back to you, Musgo Bonebreaker, and will try to unleash a bite attack against you. 22. You take 6 piercing damage total from a bite attack that finds its way onto the left arm of your person. You shrug the creature off, and that's when you see its left claw coming in for another strike against you. A 20 to hit. You suffer 7 slashing damage total as this creature slices into the side of you. Pretty nastily. That's when Syphax goes in for the disadvantage. Let's see, can he do it? Is it too late? It might be too late.
Ooh.
Come on, Syphax. Shit. Damn, Syphax has so much shit now, I can't even see what I'm trying to find. Damn you, Syphax.
It's all me, dude.
Damn it, Syphax. Ooh, yeah, Syphax busts out that protection jutsu. You can see Usku Bonebreaker as this creature is about to come slashing at you with this claw, and Syphax attempts to block the strike out of the way, but unfortunately the creature would still be able to strike upon you anyhow, regardless. But it was a good attempt from Syphax. You take note of Syphax's eagerness to try to defend you in battle, even if it isn't that effective. Unfortunate way. So we got this badger down south. Let's see, come on, badger, what do you got? Not that intelligence, that's for sure. Sorry, little badger. Let's see, it's gonna roll up next to Syphax and be like, howdy do, little Syphax. What are you up to? And perhaps take a little munch on Syphax here or there. Multi-attack, bite Syphax. Oh. Oof, Syphax's new shield dodges that strike. And then he goes in for the claw attack. Oof, Syphax. Oh, Syphax, what can you do against this? Ooh, Syphax is going to use his special ability.
Ooh.
Which just gets him out of trouble. You watch Usgo Bonebreaker as you think this is probably it for Syphax. He's about to get battered about by this other big badger that comes lumbering its way over, and its left claw like looks like it's about to like squeeze Syphax right in the head, and then Syphax just like barely leans backward and dodges the strike completely. Remarkable. How does he do it? Let's see, we've got another badger, and I think this one will come on up over toward Skeezwell Binbag. Eager for a taste of that Binbag flesh. Let's see, third round, top of the round, Syphax. He's gonna do what he can. He's gonna try to take a strike at the badger that you were dueling with, who is good Bonebreaker. Ooh, he's unable to. Ooh, he's unable to. Damn, poor Syphax. Rough. Very rough, but he maintains his composure in the line of battle. Skeezwell Binbag starting to get cornered over here by this horrid little beast. What the hell is he gonna do? With a bit of a headache, I think it's time. Shit, what does he even have? Shit. I was gonna say, a javelin would be the perfect thing. But I don't even know if he has any anymore. I think he might be out. I don't know, he has a few sharp ones, I see. Oh yeah, sick. Yeah, he'll definitely toss a sharp javelin at this goddamn
nice
little badger. Oh yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
all of a sudden a projectile comes out of the cloak of Skeezle Binbag and it finds its way into this badger beast. However, it is not enough to even slow the creature down. Skeezle Binbag using up one of his valuable sharp javelins. Manny Geld with Uzgu Bonebreaker on deck. What do you want to do?
I guess I wanna... Yeah, I guess while I was reeling back and pulling out an elemental javelin here, probably the lightning javelin.
Oh, okay.
I'm gonna give him a little poke.
Very good. Alas. You are unable to make connection with this lightning javelin. It's not, the elemental javelins aren't really best used in melee, unfortunately.
It was just a fake going for another one. That doesn't matter.
No, you have a very rough time trying to get this what would usually be a throwable and trying to work it into your combat technique. It's rough. It's rough going.
In panic, I'm going to use my defensive field, regaining 7 temporary hit points. And I'm going to move, provoking an attack of opportunity to my teammates.
Shit. Okay. All right. The badger will try to strike you, naturally. It does for 12 slashing damage. You feel the scrape. You hear the scraping, the terrible scraping sound. Of this creature's claws. It gets a pretty firm connection on you again. Unfortunately.
9 minus 7 is 2 again, okay.
Oh, I told Gma the badgers were coming. She won't believe it.
it's not good. I guess I'm done.
Very good, man.
I'm done.
Gathering back over towards your comrades, unsure of what may come. Uzgu Bonebreaker, we find our way to you, my friend. Deep in the matter of a rage, surrounded by Badger. What do you got?
Uzgu once again looks back at the disgusting coward behind the barrels. Says, do something about your pets or it's your head.
Shit.
And I take another strike at this badger in front of me.
Damn. Very good. Very good, Uzgu Bonebreaker.
Normally.
Normal style. Woof.
Oh, 34.
So in fact, like taking defensive position as you're like behind his shoulder to the left with Uzgu Bonebreaker. And Simon's like, let's go over again. And he just looks over. It's just like, there's just like, a terrible like crunching like force that just like, blows Syphax to the side as Uzgu Bonebreaker, you deliver a deafening crunch onto the top of this creature. Describe to me the critical blow as you desire it, as the creature still stands.
Uzgu swung from the side Syphax was on, just barely missing him, and struck the leg and shoulder of the beast.
Okay, very good. Very good. It won't be going anywhere anytime soon. Uzgu Bonebreaker, and the creature still yet lives. After your perfect strike.
He goes to follow it up with another one.
Oh, deafening. Another deafening blow. The creature's no more. Slain. Uzgu Bonebreaker, slain. The badger lay dead. Hold on.
Yeah, it was good.
Hold on.
Get behind me, Syphax. And that is all I can really do for him.
Syphax down with that plan. Let's see, as we've got, what do we have over here for Badger? Oh yeah, we have Manny and Geldon's like fucked up Badger. what's up with him down here? Damn, Badger's not intelligent. I'm burning all of my low rolls on these useless intelligence rolls and just saving all the juicy ones for combat. The badger continues. Unsure of what to think, it knows it wants flesh, and it seeks Manny and Geldon. It tries to take a quad attack at you, Manny and Geldon. A 16 to strike? Oof, just almost. You are saved deftly by your armor at last. Thank God another claw strike's coming. For 16 slashing damage, you are gouged into by this badger. Seeing it is deep, it is coarse, it is chunky. These creatures are just the bane of your existence, it seems to you. Armor piercers, inherently, it seems.
Yeah, no shit.
Dangerous animals. You'll be sure to ask Ooze and Bonebreaker about these creatures later, as they are rather formidable. Let's see. This guy will... Alright, strangers! And this man from beyond the barrels emerges once again and pushes down over yonder to try to in effort to save Skeezwolf and Bag. Back beast! Let's see. Fuck can I do with this guy? Ooze Good Bonebreaker inspiring the local townsfolk to get in on it themselves. Let's see, he'll bust out what he can. Oh shit, 21 to strike. I can't believe it. Nice. Dude busts out a dagger against this badger, cutting music. And manages to barely strike the beast. Clearly it won't be enough. As this giant badger's coming for Syphax. He's gonna give him a little bite. Oh, he fucks up. He's gonna allow Syphax to get away. That's nice. The creature fumbles, seeing its brethren crushed beneath like a tree trunk. its morale is shaken. This thing is gonna mash up this guy though. Finally has a chance to get back at this dude that's been holding it in its cage for all this time. It's gonna bite the fuck out of this guy. Definitely biting him. And definitely clawing the fucking shit out of him. This guy's done. this guy's out. Just go. He's done. Like, Manny, and you watch as like this guy like tries to rush to the aid of Skeezwolf Binbag, and Skeezwolf Binbag just like, whoa, like when he puts his hand back in his hand, those like starts like walking backwards as like this guy just starts getting mauled up. And he's out like that. It's fucking he gets the double deck, and then this badge is coming for Skeezwolf Binbag. He's like, no! Another claw attack. Skeezwolf Binbag's fucked up. That's it. Oof. Damn. These badgers cutting up everyone. Round like four. God. Top of the round. Syphax. And he takes the disengage action, he doesn't have to, because that badger fucked up. So he's fine. Syphax is fine. He manages to slip away from the badger. And he'll bust out next to you, Ooze Good Bonebreaker. The Syphax blast! And it's a nice bright blue, like aqua, like bubble of energy that pops against the nose of the badger. Dealing 5 naughty force damage. Alright, Syphax. Skeezwolf Binbag, really in a tight place he does not want to be, staring down like this whole creature. Oh, what can he do? What can he can like misty step out of here, can't he? He'll definitely do that.
Oh yeah.
That's the thing to do. He can do that once per short rest for free. Yeah, he's doing that. Oh shit. Oh, he's gonna try. Oh no. Oh no.
Oh no.
Oh no. It's still a spell. Oh shit. Well,
I didn't even think about that.
He can cast it for free. He's gonna try. It's like, oh, no. Oh shit. Oh. That's really bad. Oh, it's really bad. That's not good.
Really bad, not good.
Oh, it's fucking... Wait a second. Hold on. Oh, no, I can't. I can't, no, it's all wrong. Fuck.
You can do it, it's all right.
Ooh. Oh, this is rough. It's getting real rough all of a sudden. Excuse me, Ben Beck has no escape. He's gonna take the dodge action. Seeing that backfired, okay. Fucking... He only used up his bonus action trying to cast that spell, so he still has an action. He'll use his action to dodge. Doing everything he can to avoid this creature's attacks. Seeing what it did to that man. And hopefully preserving his own life. Mandine Geldon, you are up with Uzgu Bonebreaker up next. This flappy mouth badger is intent on finishing the job.
I use my defensive field.
Damn. So be it.
I regained 7 temporary hit points.
But
and
desperately needed.
I'm going to try to cast Mirror Image.
Whoa. Okay. You can fucking... Let's see. You use intelligence to cast spells, so you can make, like, an intelligence attribute roll. And you want at least a 15. To have a chance. Nope. You go to cast that shit and you're like, damn, I sure would love to cast Mirror Image and save myself from this horrible fate. That would be this bear skunk is gonna fucking kill me. And you're thinking about all these fucking things, trying and you focus and try to cast Mirror Image, and there is just this fucking like this just like it's like ringing in your ears and like this migraine that comes over you and you are...
Can I use my flash of genius? Hold on a sec. How much can that get me?
Hit me up with the deets of the flash.
I can only add my intelligence modifier to that roll, so it's only 4. It'll only get me to 12. It's not gonna be enough.
Damn. You could, but in this case, as you say, it wouldn't be enough to help you in this moment. And yep. Unfortunately, as you burn the spell slot of
what
that
a shame.
Spell, even though the spell is not cast.
What a shame. It's
and
all
you,
right.
And you are that's to represent your migraine. that you now have a headache on top of everything else.
Oh,
it's okay. I'll get through it.
Damn.
I'll live. Damn. The question is, do I want to move? I mean, it's gonna provoke an attack, but I don't know. If I stay here, I might take all 3 attacks. I'm gonna try to hold my ground, I guess.
Oh, it's gonna be a Bonebreaker on this one.
I'm gonna hold my position.
Damn.
And hope it just rolls shit.
Damn. Very good. Very good, Mandy Gildon. So be it. It was good, Bonebreaker. You do not feel the arcane flurry of your comrades in battle like you usually do. The winds of magic draw quiet in the breeze of Garza. And you still got badgers. You count 1, 2, 3. One rapid. Yeah, you look over. You look over Syphax and see that man just like crumpled up like, you know, like Peter Griffin, like not like knocked unconscious on the ground, his limbs all twisted up and fucked up. And Skeez Open Bag like has his morning star drawn and doing everything he can to keep it arm's length from the beast. And you see Mandy Gelden fucked up. Like Mandy Gelden's like limping. Like limping over right to you. And he like turns to face this badger.
I think I have something. I'm not sure how this is gonna work though.
Bust it out. What you got?
Ulzgood hoping to draw from his bardic inspiration, possibly.
Oh, okay.
And who knows, maybe pull some shit out of his ass. reaches for his bag of sus. And hoping to maybe stem the tide of battle, Ulzgood draws one of the balls of sus and throws it 30 feet next to Mandy and Gelden.
Damn, that's sick as fuck.
I can't believe it.
All right, cool. Let me to double check the bag of sus, but it can be done. It will cost your action to do so. Just so you know, it is a
okay.
You know, will consume your action straight up. But other than that, it can be done. If you still desire to do it, you can roll a D6 to determine what beast is spawned from the bag of sus.
I'm still gonna do it anyways, but
very good.
Does that include like both my attacks?
Yes. Yep. Okay. It takes up your entire action, so it keeps you from making the attack action. Yeah. Unfortunately.
I thought so.
Yep. It's as you unfortunately suspect. I think that roll is pretty good though. Before I don't want to talk too much shit. That's the one.
You spawn a rabbit.
That's the one you wanted. Dare I say it. That's a good one. Okay. Let it be known. You take one of these, you thinking in this moment, like watching Mandy Gelden, he's like, making his way over it. And like, Mandy like turns, like there's some steam that just like falls out and you're, oh shit, now's my chance. And you reach into the small pouch at your hip, Ulzgood Bonebreaker, and pull out one of these little fuzzy balls that you toss over yonder. Black in coloration. It starts to form through the air. And Mandy Gelden, out of the corner of your eye, you watch like this big, like black ball begins to like grow ever larger as it comes landing over to your side. Thrown from Ulzgood Bonebreaker, a black bear.
I can't believe it.
Is formed next to your side.
Damn. A true hero.
Black bear.
Yeah.
Boom. Boom. It's the black bear. It could have been a chicken, but instead. it is a black bear.
Shit.
Facts. Nice. Facts. Let it be. Damn. Sick. So, let's see, there's more shit in here, the bag of sus. Okay, boom, 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 use your fucking action, that's good, yep, we have the creature, it's here. Creature is friendly to you and your companions, and it acts on your turn, so we'll act, I think it will act right now. You can use a bonus action to command how the creature moves and what action it takes on its next turn. Or give it general orders, such as to attack enemies. In the absence of orders, it acts in appropriate fashion to its nature, which would be defending its pride mates. So, yeah, I mean, yeah, without any instruction, the bear will be added to the initiative.
Nice.
Let's see. And it will act. Well, I mean, yeah. We'll act on Uzgu's turn, but it might as well be after Uzgu also. Okay, so Uzgu Boom over here, action used to spawn a black bear. Anything else, my friend? You have your bonus action and movement at your disposal.
Uzgu just steps in between this bear or this badger and Syphax.
Damn.
And readies himself for battle.
A badass fucking display. The black bear is in the field. I don't know why I closed the black bear character sheet. I need it.
Come on.
I don't know what I'm just freaking out. I didn't
you
expect
saved me. Come on.
I didn't expect the bag of sus to be used so soon. Pretty sick. Pretty sick. A sick time. Let's see. So we've got the black bear. You watch Manny get on this. Black bear comes trudging its way alongside this badger here, and it's definitely going to attempt to ravage this creature. Bite attack. Ooh, yeah, 6 piercing damage coming its way. Munching. You watch this bear's like bites onto the neck of this small badger, and then like hits it with a claw. Pretty similar size. These giant badgers are like the same size as like a juvenile black bear, basically. Damn. Ooh, and the black bear gets two dank hits on the badger. They have half the chance to hit that the badgers do. Thing is ravaging it, however, all the same. Well done. Well done for the black bear. That's the black bear's turn. The badger is now going to fight the black bear.
Nice.
Oh, and you... Oh, did you Thunder Gauntlet this creature? Oh, no, you try. No, you used your action. Yeah, you used your action to try to cast your poor spell.
Yeah.
And that didn't work out so excellently, unfortunately.
No.
Damn, the badger fucks up the black bear. It is just a small creature like barrage bash next to you, Manny and Gelden, as this little black bear is just getting the shit kicked out of it now after this black bear beat up this little badger. That dude's fucked up. He's unconscious.
Yeah.
This badger is going to attempt to bite Sweet Uzgu Bonebreaker. It bites Sweet Uzgu Bonebreaker for like 4 damage, 5 damage. One or the other. Makes no difference to me. There's more attacks coming. I'll make up for it.
I'll take the 5.
Fucking... Another attack makes its way through your defenses. Mean 8 slashing damage, all said and done. And that's it for the badger in front of you. You're pleased that you kept it from assaulting Syphax any further, as it's time for Skeezle Binbag to get a little ravaging. Badger will try to bite him with disadvantage. Holy shit, Skeezle Binbag's lucky. Skeezle Binbag is so lucky. Not that lucky, but lucky right now. Holy shit, that was crazy. Skeezle Binbag's death dodge and keeps this like mortal wound. Like then turns into more of a deep glancing blow. And this badger will attempt to strike him again for a 14. Whew, which is poor Skeezle Binbag's armor class. Ooh, the badger just makes it. And Skeezle Binbag is ravaged.
No.
It's not good. It's not good. It's not good. What can he do? What can he do? Ooh. Ooh, you know what? You know what? Maybe he has something he can do here to save his life. Ooh.
Ooh.
What can be done? Oh, dude, it's all... Oh, man. It's all falling apart. Is this it? Is this it for Skeezle Binbag?
GG, Skeezle. It was nice knowing you.
Oh, man. Let's see. He's going to try to cast the shield spell as a reaction. Using his ring of defense. Gah! he will try to stop this madness from ever occurring in the first place. He's unable to cast the shield spell. Skeezwool Binbag is rendered unconscious.
No.
Ravaged. Simply ravaged unconscious by this large giant badger. That's it for Skeezwool Binbag. He's done. That's it.
Skeezwool.
Rip him. Luckily, the badger doesn't have enough action economy left to finish him off. Syphax. Speak up. Who's good? You saved me again. And he's going to look over. You got Skeezwool Binbag. And he's going to rush over to the aid of Skeezwool Binbag, the selfless, brave Syphax. And Syphax is going to roll up on the scene. Yeah, leave my friends alone! And he'll cast Mass Healing Word at level 3.
Damn. And
up to a range of 60 feet. Holy shit, that's fucking... That's a huge feat. That's fucking everybody. That's everybody. Everybody regains 4 HP.
Damn.
Global. It's like a global Syphax busts out the global heal.
I can't believe it.
Pretty sick. Syphax been warning new tricks. Skeezwool Binbag is resuscitated with 4 HP.
Poor Skeezwool.
This fucking brought back. This old man. Fucking still knocked unconscious, but stabilized now thanks to Syphax's healing might. And fucking, you know what? I think you can get the black bear too. Yeah.
Nice.
Just get everyone. Then he'll try to stab up this thing. Keep Skeezwool Binbag safe. Yeah! Yeah! Oh, he finally gets one attack in. Doing 5 slashing damage to the hindquarters of this badger. Turns to face Syphax. Skeezwool Binbag regaining his attack. He's like, oh. You see, like, the coughing Skeezwool Binbag. Skeezwool Binbag cocks back his mace and tries to strike this beast. Oh, yeah. Yep, you can do that.
Nice
9 piercing damage done to the hindquarters of this badger, distracting the badger yet again. Mandy and Gelden, you're still in a bit of a tight place yourself. Down in Badger County. What do you got planned?
I got some Thunder Gauntlet punches planned.
Oh, very good. Very good. Seems like it's just now the time.
I'm gonna...
Gosh dang it.
Yeah! Oh, no. Not this. Not like this.
It is a shame. Can you add your... A mighty 10 damage dealt. Via the second blow, can you add your Flash of Genius to the first one, or does it not work that way?
I'll need to do 2 attacks.
Damn, that's a shame.
Checks, saving throws.
Oof. Yep. Well, very good. Very good, so be it. Yep. So be it. A strike against the beast. Successfully applying your thunder dankness technique.
That's right.
Onto
it. Disadvantage against not me.
Hey, could come in handy right now. Anything else, Mandy Gilt?
No.
Okay.
I'm staying right here.
So be it. Uzgut Bonebreaker. You're in the fray, my friend. What do you desire to do?
I wish to start smashing with my Great Root Club once again.
Nice.
I could have envisioned it, but you know, just in case you wanted to mix it up. Let's see. So we're
only
talking
one of them landing.
Talking a meaty 15 damage, but from one mere strike.
Hey, Was my bardic inspiration used on that throw of the sus?
No, it was not. It was not
used
on that.
Can I use bardic inspiration on this attack roll?
You certainly may. You certainly may. Let me tell you. Let me tell you the deets.
What I gotta roll?
Let's see. Syphax is a big boy now.
Ooh.
So you can add a d8. You can add a d8. Ooh,
fuck.
Turning it up to a 14. That is the armor class of a creature.
Oh.
Roll a d6. You want at least a 4. Oh,
damn it.
No.
Brutal. Hey, you know,
we tried.
You're like, ooh, the luck of Scythax. You're like, ooh, a glancing blow. And you're like, oh, as like it like shaves the fur of the creature, you know, like as close as you could have possibly, you know, struck it. Unfortunately, no. No dice on that one, my friend, but an excellent try. Anything else? You're starting to get a feel for this great club.
I think that's it.
Okay.
Yeah.
So be it. So be it. And we've got the Black Bear, Uzku Bonebreaker, acting in unison with Uzku Bonebreaker. Let's see, we've got a bite. We've got claws.
Yeah.
Nice. Well, hey, 5 piercing damage. That'll do. The bear slays the badger.
Yeah.
That has been giving Mandy and Gelden, hunting Mandy and Gelden these last 4 or 5 rounds of combat.
Believe it.
The creature puts in the sword at last. And it will race back over to defend its master. Was good Bonebreaker.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. See, this badger's dead. Doesn't belong in the turn order anymore. These civilians are dead. They don't belong in the turn order anymore. Let's see, we've got a badger. It's gonna try to attack you, Was good Bonebreaker. Like the fool it is. Oh, it strikes you for 7 piercing damage in total. Will attempt to strike you again with its claw attack for another meaty 15 slashing damage coming your way. Hot dog.
Mm-hmm.
Disturbing. And you're feeling the burn. You're feeling the burn after all that. That's for sure. These badgers are, badgers are tough sons of bitches. As you may or may not know, Uzku Bonebreaker, you definitely know. It's
Oh, yeah.
It's a lesson reaffirmed to you now in this moment. As this one will take a claw attack at Syphax. Syphax like, oh! Fucked up from that. Really bad. 15 slashing damage in Syphax. That's bad. That's not good. And the badger will take another claw strike at Syphax. Syphax just getting fucked up so bad. Just getting absolutely obliterated right now. This badger just carving out his guts. It's fucked
Damn
up.
It.
Round
Damn
5.
It.
Top of the round. Me oh my. Who else enters into the fray? Ho ho ho! Whoop whoop! It's the sound of the police. Whoop whoop! It's the sound of
the
beast.
Watch.
Whoop whoop! It's the sound of the police. Whoop whoop! It's the sound of the beast. It should be said. It's only been like 30 seconds.
True.
But you know, it's really hard. Our last hour and a half is really only like 30 seconds in fucking combat.
True.
So I mean, you know, police response time pretty good. All things considered, Manny and Gelden, you start to hear the shouts and like the glimmering of light, you know, sun shining off the top of, you know, metallic armor as the authorities have arrived, and they will be they'll be stepping it up. Clear the way. And the police be here.
matter.
Let's say.
Let's throw him. We get lost. Tell you what.
Let's throw.
Go away. We got this handled.
Skeezle, been back.
Civilian on the ground. Skeezle on the ground. We got this.
Hey, get in someone else's way. Sci-fax. This is fucking. Who do you think you are? Let's see. Homeboy's gonna bust out. Gah! Damn, Badger Merchant, we told him this would happen. and fucking and homeboy runs up, man, he yelled. And you see, you know, fucking first time you're getting like a real good look at these men in arms, clad in blue with these, you know, rather, it should be said, slick brimmed like kettle hats for these dashing helmets. Dressed in blue gambesons. See, this one takes out a very large caliber crossbow. Definitely a two-hander. And he kind of takes a knee and thwonk, there's a, you know, large, twang from this crossbow as it comes sailing over toward that fucking badger, piercing into the side of it rather deeply. You hear the roaring of the creature. It's like, damn, these things are so slow, and he's gonna spend the rest of his turn fucking reloading that thing. Syphax, oh shit, watch where you're shooting those! And Syphax goes in for some short sword cuts upon this beast, hitting one, fucking up the other. Syphax finds herself a bit on the back foot all of a sudden. Happens quick. Sees will bin bag. Just keep wailing on him! And he'll go in for a strike as well. doing just that. Nice 10 piercing damage. Getting a little use out of that Morning Star. Mandy and Gelden, you are up. The authorities have arrived, but there are still badgers here.
Mandy and Gelden spins around and runs up to help, aiming his palm pistol at the beast and fires.
I'm shooting that gun in front of the police.
Hey, they don't know what it is.
They will soon enough. as you raise up your palm, and there's like a puff of smoke, and then like this guy's reloading the crossbow, so he just gets like watch you go over, and he's just like right, and there's a little puff of smoke, a tiny flash, no projectile, but the creature is struck. In the side once again, everyone's just like pin cushioning this creature in the side. And it's looking pretty fucked up. The next attack probably will kill it. Is there anything else, Mandy and Gelden?
I just wish I could fire my gun twice. No, that's it.
Damn, can't you?
Well, technically I should be able to.
I think you can.
All right.
I think you really can. I don't think I have any like custom rules stopping you.
I'll fire it again then.
Because you have like that. You have that unlimited ammo thing. Right? You know that.
I have the quick reload thing.
And you also have don't you have like something else that makes it so like ammunition is less of a loading problem for you? I don't know. I feel like you have a few things.
Yeah.
Anyway, yes. I mean, I'll allow it.
Cool.
I'm gonna
fire again.
Yeah, it's an attack. It's an attack. And see, you're a shot. You know what? Fear God, you like that? Here, I'll give you some more. And you just shoot again, and you shoot this creature right in the eye, and the creature's dead. And then you hear the guardsman over yonder as like this creature like stumbles and plops down to the dirt. And he's like, whoa, woof. But a puff of smoke, and the creature's gone. at least. Anything else, Mandy and Gelden?
I'm gonna use my remaining 10 feet. Move this way. And that's it.
Okay. All right. Very good. Very good. Who's your bone breaker? You've got a badger who seems to be in pretty good spirits still. What you thinking?
Wolzu's getting mad at all this damage he's been taking, so he's flipping up the switch with another reckless attack.
Yeah.
Add in a little wrath hue on this first one.
Oof, the ultimate technique. Abandoning all accuracy for fucking striking down the fucking enemy with your ferocious rage.
Yeah.
Oh my god, please, no more. Let's see, that's 27 points of damage off the first strike, as it's a center of mass, full impact blow. This creature is large enough that you can afford to throw aside your fucking accuracy and take this full on strike against this fucking beast. And another 15 damage does the deed, Uzgud Bonebreaker. How does the creature perish?
Just a good old smash to the noggin, knocking its lights out.
It is such, Uzgud Bonebreaker, as the dazed creature is felled, and the combat, Crimson Bones, comes to an end. None of the badgers intelligent enough to unleash their brethren over yonder. Perhaps rather fortunately, as these creatures prove to be a bit fortuitous. And now, Crimson Bones, as the dust settles, you are left with some guardsmen, which I'm sure will have some questions for you. But we'll catch that back after our break.
That wasn't me.
What gun?
What do you mean?
There was no firearm.
It was a spell.
There is no what spell?
Spells. Don't claim what you don't know, sir.
Both aren't allowed. Where we last left our heroes, you boys just finished up a bit of a scuffle with these giant goddamn badgers, which put up quite a bit of a formidable fight. It turns out they are quite the dank creatures. Right now the courtyard is all but abandoned, except for the Crimson Bones, the four of you, as it currently stands. The unconscious self-acclaimed keeper of the giant badgers. The other cowering man, who was like a peasant laborer of some caliber, who was cowering over by the minecart over yonder, and now four guardsmen. Four men-at-arms of Garza, one finishing reloading his crossbow, tucks it under one arm. He's like, oh, what happened here?
They happened upon us. Some keeper let these badgers loose. I was only trying to help.
Is that so?
I swear, I try to discreetly tuck my pistol away.
Do remove those cloaks so I can get a finer look at you, stranger.
Manion Gelden will remove his cloak, exposing his large metal frame.
Oh, it's fucking. Some murmurs and so on, and two of the guardsmen kind of like ready themselves, and fucking the guy that you're speaking to up front kind of like raises up his hand for them to chill out. He's like, well, I appreciate the help, strangers. It's fortunate that you were here, it seems to me.
Huh. I wouldn't say it's quite fortunate. My colleague is on the ground, and I'm slowly bleeding out internally.
Are you in need of aid? and the guardsmen move forth two over in the direction of like the unconscious Badger Keeper and Skeezwill Binbag and Syphax. Syphax, who is tending to Skeezwill Binbag at this time, and the other guardsman is kind of making his direction over toward you, who is good Bonebreaker. They kind of like notices your stature and kind of like keeps you like 20 feet away or so, just kind of like, you know, checking out the scene, and it seems like you are mostly talking with this one guardsman, Andy and Gildan, with the crossbow.
He's like, I tell him that I could use some aid, and I could do it myself if it wasn't for this damn magic shield.
you must be new. Forgive the Dram Ward, it is by royal decree. And he takes out a potion of healing and hands you a potion of healing.
Oh, I'll take it graciously, thanking the man.
He nods.
Slurp it down immediately.
He nods. He's like, say, are you with Beric Dondarrion or something like that? You seem like a pretty colorful cast of characters.
I know not of what you speak, but we're simply passing through. We mean no trouble, and we don't mean to get in your way.
Have no fear, citizen. I'm simply inquiring of the nature of your traveling arrangement. And he kind of like looking you over a little suspiciously, and then like peering over your shoulder, like, you know, the huge hulking beast that is Uzgud Bonebreaker standing upon like his pile of badgers.
Uzgud interjects. Do all travelers bear attacks by these kind of badgers here?
No. Unfortunately, it is the... We have the occasional disturbance, and I'm sorry to say that you were just on the receiving end of it, and I must apologize for that. We'll see to it that the keeper of this property is
like a little aid here.
So be it.
Oh, what's my role in a potion?
Oh, it's shit. What is it? It's just a plain Jane.
2d4 plus two.
Maybe.
1d4 plus two.
I think it's 2d4. It's been a little while.
Yeah.
It's been a little while.
It's a normal healing potion, right? Not a lesser.
Correct. Yep. Plain Jane. So it's 2d4 plus two.
Okay.
As you rightly surmise, and he hands you over a
really?
Potion, Uzgud Bonebreaker, but he doesn't release it. Until you respond to his question that he asked. Oh, fucking, it's a little sour, unfortunately, Mandy and Gelton. But you know, it's
good. We'll strength check that.
Ooh,
try and take
right.
it.
What's your name, travelers? As you like force it out of his hand. Go for the athletics check. Are you still raging? So you can do it with advantage if you're still raging.
Oh yeah.
He's like, it's close, but you know, like eventually he relents. But you know, it's fucking, you know, not too bad.
I will tell him I'm Uzgud. We are the Crimson Bones.
Crimson Bones, you say?
Yes. And I will down the potion.
Very good, very good. 2d4 plus two as well. A standard healing potion, as it were. So, Crimson Bones, you're passing through, Garza, it were. I must inquire As to the nature of your arrangement here, are you some type of mercenary group?
I wouldn't call it mercenary group.
We're more just shopping.
We're more adventurers looking for supplies after a long time in the Fog Forest. I'm sure you've heard of it.
Yeah, some certainly know where I would go. The Crimson Bones, a band of adventurers, you say? I don't suppose you have any identification.
In what form? I wouldn't say I do.
Why? If you were a registered adventuring band, you would have the seal of the Mercenaries Guild, no doubt. Are you not familiar?
Oh, I'm familiar. I just, I would never register with such a group. I try to lie to his face.
make a deception check, man. You know. He's like, the Mercenaries Guild is of great renown. Barak Tondarian's group was a member of it. The most prestigious adventuring bands, even the most lousy adventuring bands. Everyone is a member of the Mercenaries Guild. It's simply the thing to do. I'm sure if you seek out Delrond, he will see to your utmost care. And he's like, come. and he just points over yonder, and from like the courtyard where you guys are, a good 1,000 feet or so way over to the fucking northeast, is this huge tower that reaches high into the sky, and there's quite a few black birds and so on that are hovering around the very top of said tower. He's like, that, my friend, is the Mercenaries Guild. I implore you, Crimson Bones, to go over to the Mercenaries Guild, make yourselves known. I appreciate your help today.
Appreciate your attempts at assisting, as late as they were. Perhaps we will visit this Mercenaries Guild and see what the competition is like.
And then he bows his head in a way, and you guys have the Mercenaries Guild unlocked on your maps, or, you know, shown to you quite clearly. He's like,
nice.
Do be wary, though, if you're new to the City Traveler, of the 6 points. Gestures over yonder. He's like, in between here and the Mercenaries Guild, if you were to go straight there, you would run into a district known as the 6 points. It is the slum of the city. I hate to say it, that not all of Garza shines. It is where the poor, decrepit criminals and gutter snipes of society dwell. I advise to steer clear of such an area, and head to the square first, and then head to the Mercenaries Guild from there. It'll be a much safer journey.
I appreciate the word of warning. I will see to it.
That's all I can do. Seems we have this man over here that can tell us what happened, and perhaps the potential perpetrator of this, and if it's any other way, I'm sure we'll have no trouble finding you.
Oh, you better hope so. I give him a bit of a smirk and a smile as I start to walk away.
What is your name, sir? He asks you, Manny Gelden.
I am Sir Yeldon. That is what I'm known by in these lands.
I'm James.
Well met, James.
He gives another nod. He's like, "Hi. We have a bit of a mess to clean up." And they start going about.
Oh, we'll help with that. And I grab Syphax and we start butchering these badgers.
All right.
We need rations, baby. I want their claws.
The guardsmen are oof. So be it, I suppose. Less work for us. Okay. All right. Very good. Very good. Seems like your traveling band isn't going anywhere, Manny Yeldon, until they've had their way with these sweet badgers. Let's get some survival checks. Yes, Manny Yeldon.
I was gonna say I stand by the guard, saying, "Don't mind my friends and his barbaristic behavior. I told you we are from the Fog Forest.
Yeah,
that's all we know."
Very good. Very good. Well. There's already a mess, so I suppose there's no harm done. And they go about doing their thing, and another, like, you know, 2-4 guards show up over the course of the next, you know, half hour or so. That was a good Bonebreaker and Syvax be carving up these badgers. All right, it was a bone breaker. Let's get a survival check with advantage, because Syphax will be helping
18.
You. Oh shit! Okay, you can roll again flat if you want. See if you roll any higher.
Try it.
You might as well try. Oof. Oof. Okay. All right. 18 it is. I would say. What are you going for in particular? Do you want just parts and pieces, or you? I mean, you're going for meat on this
rations one, and then claws.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, you get 10 rations of raw meat, all said and done, and I'll say you get 10 giant badger claws, all said and done, over the course of a half hour, hacking it up, macking it up. You get the biggest and finest. Caesar Binbag starting to sweat a little bit at the sight of all the guardsmen. He's like keeping well, and he's like refusing medical aid. He's like, "Oh no, I'm fine." And he's like coughing up blood. he's in a terrible state. Come on, Syphax, come on, help your old man out of here, will you? Oh yeah. Like, help poor Skeezle come back, limp his way out of here. He has seen better days, that's for sure. Poor Skeezle come back is gonna be fucking hurt big time. Alright, well. With that, Usku Bonebreaker, you're skinning complete. and some more guardsmen arriving. It should be said, you know, they're casing out the joint now. They asked, during this time, you know, this half hour, they asked the nearby dude what happened, and he pretty much tells them, you know, badgers busted out. That dude was like, "Oh shit, my badgers." Fucking Crimson Bones came in, saved the day, saved the little girl. He tells them that. That was sick. And they're like, oh shit. And then fucking James asks you, Manny Yeldon, if that's true.
It's true. I couldn't have let it happen. I saw it happen right in front of my face.
Done a good deed this day, then. That's for sure. I've not given you that aid in vain, it seems to me.
No. I would never let such an innocent being fall at the hand of such terrible beasts.
You hear that, boys? and then the guardsmen, you know, like all seven of them, like now at this point, they're like, Crimson Bones. Yeah, that's some, you know, hey, it's very good. It's good. People are buying it. People are loving it.
Friendly in the town of Garza.
Not bad.
Reputation up.
Not bad. Not, you know, really, truth be told, not bad. Not bad. You know, if you can get like a reputation point, you know, you're pretty close to getting one, I would say.
Nice.
Your name's been spread out there in a positive way. And now, Crimson Bones, what do you desire to do?
I would like to ask Syphax if we think we can get a room at Red Face Jack's as a as a place of rest and recuperate after such a terrible encounter.
Yeah, sure, that's a good idea. I mean, it is still only noon, though. It's up to you.
Well, we might as well visit the square and see what we can find and then make our way back there, I suppose. It seems like we'll certainly need a rest after this.
I agree. He
spits a little blood out of his mouth. Says, I'm going to the bar and with the intentions of hanging out for a couple hours and spending some hit dice.
Damn. Damn.
I hear that, Syphax. Sounds like a good idea.
Ah, well, I mean, if it was good Bonebreaker's going, I guess I have to go.
Come along, you can drag Skeezbull there. I'm
all
sure
right,
you're up
right.
for it.
Okay, come on, Skeezbull. And Syphax takes Skeezbull, spit back, like, arm over his shoulder. And he's like, help him over yonder. You guys make your way to Red Face Jack's.
Nice.
Ah.
Losgood walks right up to the bar. Ask how much for a pint.
Hey, relax. Relax, Losgood Bonebreaker. Slow down. Slow down. I'm not playing the town music yet. Jesus.
Oh, excuse me.
Christ almighty.
What about the town music? Come on.
Sweet Crimson Bones.
This good struts in the town.
y'all making your way. Y'all making your way. All seems to be rather well. Leaving the market district after about a minute or two of travel. It's a pretty hustling and bustling day. You guys are heading now back into like the herd of traffic that you gentlemen like traverse through to get back through this way. And you're kind of all pushed into a single file line as you see many a sight going down the 200 feet back toward the large structure painted red that is Red Face Jack's. And you all walk up over to the front door. There's some people loitering about. But other than that, it seems like all is well. Who's the first to enter?
Who's good?
I knew it.
Who's good Bonebreaker? You open up the saloon-style doors, you know, just that you can push open rather dramatically and enter into the space. Let's see. Let me get this Red Face Jack's action. It is a rather lush and dank wooden interior. Let's see. Do I have a? No. Anyway, it's a rather dank and lush interior. Bunch of, you know, dining tables and etc. Just about everything you would expect. And there's a small step-up incline that leads to, you know, the other half of the room, which is, you know, slightly elevated, as it were. And there's like this grand counter, with all different types of, you know, slain beasts, you know, heads and so on that are strewn upon like a top support beam. You can see quite a few different people behind the counter. You spot a decent amount of patrons. Looks like a good like two dozen patrons or so. And the house is only like half full or so. You know, this is a rather large dining area. And then that is when you hear the cackling of a large orc who pulls up from behind the counter, from beyond, like, you know, ingredient shelving, turning the corner, a large green dank orc dressed in like a wife beater and some type of short equation with a rather small chef's hat upon his large like underbite orc jaw. swung over his shoulder a dank ass, like two-handed meat cleaver. Incredibly, incredibly dank in Norway. And he's like laughing. He's like,
fish? We ain't serving no fish in here. It's chicken all day, baby.
What do you want to do, Crimson Bones? Says you as you have entered into Red Face Jack's. Scythax is like, oh shit, it's Red Face Jack.
We all need to go get a drink at the bar.
I agree. I will approach the bar with Uzgold.
Do you all sit at the bar? Is that what's going on right now?
Yeah. Pile in.
Like puts, you know, like drops skis on like the only the stool next to him. And Red-Faced Jack comes over and he's, you know, this big handlebar mustache having orc, you know, massive underbite with these huge fangs. You know, dank, you know, just dank build. Could be at least, you know, probably like 6.5 feet tall. Some shit like that, you know, he's big. He's fat. He's green. He's mean. Except for the big warm smile that he's got on his face. He's like,
welcome to Red Face Jack's. I'm Red Face Jack. What can I get for you, travelers? I haven't seen you around these parts before.
We're new around here, but we're looking for some fine ale. Particularly strong one for my friend down there, and I point to Skeez while he's barely conscious.
No problem. Find a sale, we'll run you 4 gold a mug.
You kind of like eyes you all over, seeing that you're all like fucked up.
4 gold a mug, isn't that a kind of highway robbery around these parts? I thought this was the ale capital of the world.
That's the price.
Redface Jack says, giving you this big, you know, like foul, big foul grin.
I suppose on the first round, but if we keep drinking, perhaps we can get a discount. We might be looking for a room as well, if that can incentivize you.
Well, you didn't say that. That changes things quite a bit. Well. I've got plenty of rooms for what? The 4 of you?
How many do you have available?
Well, I've got, let's see, at least 2 rooms with 2 beds per room, if that'll suffice.
I don't suppose why not. It should work just fine.
Very good. It's 10 gold per room for the night.
Deal, and I will put, 32 gold on the counter for the ale and the rooms.
Okay, very good, excellent, so be it.
How much was it for the ale again?
It was fucking like 4 gold per mug, so it's a lot.
I will match Mandian for a round.
Damn, very good. So be it. Coughing is like,
I like you guys already. Say, why do y'all look so roughed up? So
he's like scooping his gold over yonder.
I throw a badger claw on the table. These things are wandering the streets.
Ah, down by the market district again, I'm sure. It happens every now and then.
The guards didn't seem very worried about it either. They were there quick, but not quick enough.
They do what they can. Most of them are good folk.
And as he's like pouring you guys these drinks from this, you know, this incredibly large cask of ale that's like up high, basically only somewhere like more or less he can reach. As you see, you know, there's another like two or three, you know, it's like humans that are that are moving about and serving the various tables over yonder and so on. And let's see.
He's like, that Captain Nightwood, he's a good watt. That Sergeant in Arms, Sergeant Barrows, he's a crude one that. You boys best watch out for him.
Sergeant Barrows, huh?
That was, let's see, I'll put that down in the chat. That was Sergeant in Arm Barrows. And Captain Nightwood is also mentioned.
So, yep. Those two have never gotten along.
I'll have to keep an eye out for him then. I mean, don't think I've seen a Captain Barrows yet, or Sergeant at Arms Barrows yet.
Well, keep your voice down, son. Hopefully, you won't have to meet him anytime soon.
And he cheers goes, to that, I say.
Yeah, as he goes ahead and passes you all your first round at this time, Sapphire's like, all right, to the Crimson Bones.
To the Crimson Bones, and
yeah.
I cheers everyone for downing my drink.
Sci-Fax, Skeezball is like, you know, the least enthusiastic. You know, just, you know, it's going, you know. In one of his moods from being a little sullied in combat and likely still a little hungover from the Dram Ward poisoning. And it is a fine ale, gentlemen. Probably one of the finest in the land. Worth every penny, it should be said. Hits you all smooth and whimbers you all up. And that's when Red Face Jax kind of like crosses his arms as he's watching Sci-Fax, as he's cheering with you guys. And then Sci-Fax is drinking back. And his eyes kind of look over. And he and Red Face Jack are just like making eye contact. And like, Sci-Fax, like, you know, like looks away. He's like, oh, yeah. And Sci-Fax like takes out his little cricket pet.
Redface Jack's like, I know you don't, boy.
Sci-Fax's like, maybe I was here like a long time ago, maybe, but not for a long time. You know? And Sci-Fax's gonna have to roll for that one. he's on his own there.
Maybe in a different life.
Redfish Jack's fucking like,
I don't know. You look a lot like Sci-Fax Timber Hollow to me.
It's like, no. Nope. I'm Sci-Fax Cravenborn.
Of the Crimson Bones.
Yeah, you hear that?
Was good interjects. Trying to start up a conversation.
Well, it might help Sci-Fax in this. And it might help Sci-Fax. Damn, it helped Sci-Fax.
He's like, Craven, the Crimson Bones. I haven't heard of the Crimson Bones. What's that? That's you?
That's our group. A bunch of adventurers.
Adventurers? Like Beric Dondarrion? Shame what happened.
Everyone
to
keeps
him.
Mentioning that name. You do know what happened to him, right?
I know it as they say it. He entered into the Mountain of Gilgamesh and never returned. Oh, terrible, terrible. Killed by Dram the Dark, they say. Oh, that fetcher, if I had my hands on him, I'd wring his neck. And that Iran Burnbath, too.
Iran Burnbath? Manny Gelden looks up.
I
what do you know about him?
Stalks the knights. Stalks the streets of Garza at nights, he does. They say people hear him cackling in the alleyways at night. I say it's all hee-haw. We haven't seen the likes of Dramadark for at least 2 years or so now.
Well, I say you better keep on the lookout. You never know.
Don't worry, stranger, I'm always watching. Say, what do you know about Beric Dondarrion?
And he looks over at you, who's good Bonebreaker.
I know that he's dead, and I know that one of our members had his sword. That's about all I really know of him.
Oh-ho! You say? That's quite the feat. That must have mean you were in the Mountain of Gilgamesh, too.
Yeah, we walked out of there after him.
So, rumors are true. Indeed. The successors of Beric Dondarrion are here, perhaps. Well. Interesting indeed. Times are changing, it seems. You've got big shoes to fill. But you look like y'all are tough enough.
Yeah, I think we got it. I'm a pretty big guy. I can fill those shoes.
I like you, stranger. What's your name?
Who's good Bonebreaker?
Oh, I'm Red Face Jack.
I'll dap him up. He's the orc, right?
He is the orc. Yeah, he's big. Yeah. Too. He's huge. He's fucking massive.
Yeah. I like him. He's cool.
His bicep is like the size of Syphax.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, it was like all of them. And he's been leaning over on the counter, like, big times. You know, like totally checking you guys out, you know, big time.
Excuse me, got some more customers to deal with.
And he kind of, like, you know, lumbers his way over to one end of the bar. And you just, like, see him, like, pick up, like, a goat carcass, and he just, like, grabs two ends of it and just, like, rips it, you know, just, like, rips it clean in half.
He's like, ah, that's how you do it, quit wasting time.
Uzgood likes that.
It's Red Face Jack, dude. It's him. It's like, oof. Man, that was close. I didn't want Red Face Jack to recognize me. Syphax whispers to you, Mandy and Gelden.
Mandy and Gelden says loudly and not whispering, with the drink getting to him. What did you fight Syphax? You and Red Face Jack fight before? What's going on?
There, you know,
oh god. What happened between Syphax and Red Face Jack that was so bad and shouldn't be brought up?
Syphax was trying to cover your mouth. He's like, no, shh, 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 shh. We don't
he
talk
said,
about
this is
that
the
here.
Best place in the city. Why is Syphax a Red Face
hey,
Jack?
On. Stop it, man. Yelling, stop it, man. Yelling. And then Red Face Jack's like,
What's all this talking about Red Face Jacks around here?
And then he comes like, comes back over. And he's like looming over the bar. And poor Syphax is like, you know, like strangling you. He's like, oh, nothing.
sec. I don't mean that. What's going on over here? Well, yo,
Mandian looks at Red Face Jack, says, "Oh, Red Face Jack. I love Red Face Jack." And spills half his drink down his face when he tries to drink it.
I think that one's had enough.
And then Redface Jack's like waddles back over. Snapback's like, "Whew. Whew, man. Whew. That was close. It almost happened again."
What's Zyfax? What's wrong? Well,
I
seem so flustered. Why don't you just have your drink?
We can't talk about it here. I'll drink. That's fine. No problem. That's all I want. It's just drink it. I'm Zyfax. Since Zyfax goes about drinking, as well as Skeezle being back, they enjoy their drinks.
Yeah.
For the evening. And you gentlemen have a few hours to kill. I mean, you know, how many hours are spent out of the bar? Like an hour or two?
Yeah, enough to get some hit points back, probably.
Yeah, enough to spend like 3 or 4 hit die.
Okay. Well, so be it. And that's, you know, 3 or 4 hours then. 3 or 4 short rests coming up in rapid succession. You boys just are chilling at Red Face Jack's. Okay. All right. Well, 4 hours go by. 4 hit dice coming your way, gentlemen. You guys can roll up to 4 hit dice. Everyone, nice. Basically. Skeezle Binbag will definitely do that. Oh.
No.
So awesome.
Good enough.
Binbag's like, "What were those skunk things? They tore up my guts."
Snapback's like, "I don't know. Some kind of like big badger, I guess. They're pretty mean."
I've never seen those in my life. Uzgold was tearing apart, though. How do you learn how to do that, Uzgold?
I fought those things before.
You used to hunt them. You used to trap them.
They taste good.
Taste good? You'd hunt those just for their meat? You're crazy.
And for the fight? Come on. You felt how those things hit.
Oh, I felt it.
How do you think you get this strong?
Oh, I don't know. Skeezle was looking too weak. Wasn't looking too strong after fighting them.
Sidebacks laughs. You guys notice that, like, you know, the traffic of the tavern has changed, certainly, as like now you guys are getting rolling over toward like more like dinner, like evening time. And now, like, a lot of, like, you know, like, it's filled, you know, it's a full house now, as, like, you know, a lot of, like, the field workers from, like, their, you know, their long days work is done, laborers are all here, and etc. There's even some guardsmen, perhaps off duty here, drinking and enjoying their time in Red Face Jack's as well. Quite the popular establishment, it seems. And it's getting a bit more lively. Regardless, over the course of the 4 hours, you gentlemen are looking pretty, you know, spend the time recuperating, drinking. And of course, shooting the shit with Red Face Jack's like,
"Yeah.
So, strangers, where'd you come from?"
To to marry
some fog forest.
The fog forest. What would you be doing around them? Around those parts?
That's where our partner comes from. It's pretty nice place once you get to know it.
I find that a little hard to believe.
A big man like you couldn't handle the fog forest? Come on.
Yeah, big orc like you could do it.
Maybe so. But I've heard some terrible things come from down those parts.
I feel like a red-faced jack's location would do just fine in the fog forest. Don't see why you haven't given it a try yet.
I'm not so sure about that.
And Redface Shacks has many other customers to serve, unfortunately, at this point, so he bids you all adieu, gentlemen, and gives, you know.
Wait, before you leave, we need our room key.
Yeah.
Before you get lost.
I was about to say. Gives you guys your room keys.
Very good.
One to Manning Guild and one to Uzugu Bonebreaker, I suppose. Nice. As like chaperones of the respective rooms. How many rooms were bought? Two, right?
Two.
Two rooms. Yeah, the two rooms.
Two rooms with two beds each.
Nice.
As it is. Yeah, very good. Yeah, so you gentlemen have your room keys for
very
your
good.
Rooms tonight. Redface Shack tells you they are upstairs. Over yonder. He gestures over yonder to where you may, you know. Find your sweet rooms.
Very good. I would ask him for another ale to take to my room. Before
well.
We rest for the evening.
Very well. He gives,
I'm assuming
he
that's what we're planning on doing.
Huh? It's up to you, my Crimson Bones, but Redface Jax gives you a ale on the house.
Oh,
for nice.
Being, for being a first-time patron.
Gladly will take that.
Thank you, Sir Jack. I appreciate it.
Keep up the good work.
And Redface Jack gestures over yonder, and you can see over in the corner of the bar is like a squadron of like guardsmen who are fucking, you know, over in the corner at like a round table, all, you know, and they raise their mugs to you, Mandy and Gellin, as you the Crimson Bones stand up around the bar.
I will raise my glass back to them and sip it as I go towards the stairs.
Nice. Damn. Working out already.
Working.
Just making friends everywhere. What can I say?
The Crimson Bones, heroes. Heroes of Garza already. And you gentlemen make your way upstairs. And how are we looking for room division tonight? Who's in what room?
I'm taking the best room.
They're both of pretty substantial quality.
I suppose I'll take Skis well, and I'll make sure he doesn't die in his sleep due to his wounds.
Very good. Very
good.
Oh my
god, poor Skis well.
Yeah. Yeah, very good. Very good. So be it. You bunk with Skis open bags. Oh yeah! I get to hang out with Uzugu Bonebreaker, Syfax says, as Uzugu and Syfax will be sharing the bunk with you.
Sounds good.
And this, you know, you guys have at least a good 2 or 3 hours before you have to call it sleepy bye for the night. So there's plenty of time for some crafting hijinks or what have you.
Very good.
Oh, you know what I just thought of? Where or what happened to the bear?
The bear, you say? Oh shit! Oh yeah. Oh shit! Oh yeah. Yep. The bear would be here. People have just been like, you know, keeping a distance from you. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Yeah. I mean, unless you made any attempt to like hide it or whatever, the bear is just here. The bear's the townspeople, or you know, you got a bit more like, you know, leeway than usual. But most people aren't really that fazed by a bear, because you know there's fucking like elk whore and shit walking around, and you never know when fucking, you know, it's not, you know, and like giant badgers, you know, that's why, you know, so really, you know, really a bear, you know, it isn't too outlandish. And it seems to be relatively well behaved, but yeah, no, you just had this bear like in Red Face Jack's and this whole time.
Well, I'm definitely taking the bear with me.
Okay, all right, Ben. Oh, very good. As it's been for the last few hours, you are in your room with Syphax and the bear. And a good 2 or 3 hours passed, gentlemen. What is it you two desire to do, if anything?
Oh. Could I work on, like, the part that adapts into my suit for, like, my modules, but not, like, finish the module? Is that, like, a generic enough part that I can make to, like, slot into there? To reduce my crafting time later?
Oof. I mean, I guess so. I mean, you could probably just start trying to make a module if you really want to.
If you dare.
Which one do you have in mind? I guess it depends.
I would like to. Let me take another peek, but I had one in mind.
Yeah, you better. You better double check.
Okay.
There are some requirements.
Yes.
And who knows what else?
I mean, I have to get the defensive gauntlet module that I've been, you know, thinking about for so long.
Damn. Damn.
That will take my Catablipus tail, though.
Oh.
Nice.
Yup.
That requires a Catablipus.
I mean, you tail. Do have the Catablipus tail.
I do have it. I do have it.
So, I mean, shit. They don't want, you know. I mean, shit. You have some scrap metal, don't you?
I have quite a bit. Let me find out. I have 55 scrap metal equaling 25 pounds. Or 22 and a half pounds.
Damn, that's pretty good. So you could probably have, like... You probably take, like, 10 scrap metal and your fucking Catablipus tail and forge it into... And, you know, attempt... to start forging it into this Catablipus module.
I will certainly start that.
Okay. Alright, very good. Very good, let it be known. So be it. Why don't you get me a... Oh, you sick fuck. How the hell am I supposed to make you roll for this Catablipus module? Probably an intelligence check flat. Let's go with that.
Intelligence check flat.
Let's go with that. That's whatever you want to say.
I had a flash of genius. And I'm going to add my intelligence modifier to that.
So be it.
Making it 20.
Okay. All right. Well, that's good. That's good. It can only help.
I hope so.
Getting a little Catablipus action. Let's see. We need use of the smith's tools, of course.
Yes.
I'm sure.
Which I have proficiency for.
Yes. You can roll the smith's tools if you dare.
I will. Attribute?
Using your intelligence. Let's use intelligence this time. Look at that.
Look at that.
Ferocious.
So good.
20 and 22. I mean, it's hard not to argue with those numbers. I mean, hard to argue, oh well.
Argue with me.
Oh, I might. It's not over yet. No, good. 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 I mean, I would say over the course of 3 hours, you get like a quarter of the way done.
Nice.
But you are actually at constructing it.
Very good.
As it stands, and you are well on your way to. You're not sure what, unlocking perhaps the potential of your suit in full.
Nice. I added a 25% defensive module to my inventory.
Oh, good. Excellent. Excellent. I was going to say mark it down in chat, but that, you know, that works. That works.
Nice.
I like that.
I'll mark it in the chat just for a timeline.
Yep, same. So be it. Who's good, Bonebreaker? Are you up to anything with Syphax and your bear for the last 2 to 3 hours?
What have I been doing with Syphax and the bear?
Well, if anything.
You don't want to know.
Or crafting
I hit like
or
a little like hour long workout.
Nice.
And you know, I encourage Syphax to join, but he doesn't have to. He can do his own thing.
Yeah, he seems kind of like busted up about something, you notice.
You know what, I'll ask into that. What's going on, Syphax?
God damn, you know? It's been a long time since I've been back here.
Yeah, what happened with the barkeeper there?
It's a long tale, Wuzgo Bonebreaker, but I'll tell it to you straight, because you're one of my best friends, you know? And we're members of the Crimson Bones, and we gotta be honest and stick together. Well, it was, you know, back in the day, I ran into some debt, you know, and I ended up owing a lot of money to some boys around town, and that's why I ended up weaving Garza with Arvo in the first place. Heading out down to refugees for us.
How much money you end up owing these boys?
It's not good, Uzco Bonebreaker, I tell you right now. Like thousands, I think. And I'm sure the interest is only getting worse. I'm sure the interest has only gotten worse over time, because that's the type of cats those people are, you know what I'm saying? They're real cutthroat losers.
Who exactly do you owe this to?
Oh, man. They're real nasty folks. Let's see, he'll tell you, oh, I owe it to Rolosi the Diamond.
Rolosi the Diamond?
Yeah, dude, I'll write that shit down. I'll put that one down, that one's a serious one.
Yeah, I'll remember that one.
Yeah, he's a pretty serious dark elf. He used to run a gang called the 40 Thieves. Help us down the 40 Thieves.
40 Thieves.
They ain't no joke, you know what I'm saying?
And what got you this far in debt with these people?
It was my pops, you know? He used to be some kind of super hardcore gambler, and then when he passed on, his debt moved on to me. I tried doing what I could to pay off the debt, but I wasn't any good at playing any of my songs or anything like that, and, you know.
That is just dishonorable.
I never ended up making a debt.
Bring me one of these people if you ever see them. I will attempt to settle this with you.
So, well, thanks, Wuzgo Bonebreaker. We can't make too much of a fuss, you know what I'm saying? They got the law on their side.
And I got this, and I pat my giant root club.
Nice.
It's fucking, it's big too. It's a big fat ass root club. Mm-mm-mm. Delicious. Absolutely delicious. Yeah, I mean, with that, Syphax hits the training regiment with you for a little while, you know? Doing your thing.
Good.
Seems to be feeling a little bit better about that. Ska, do you think we're going to go to the Mercenaries Guild, Uzga Bonebreaker? And be official Crimson Bones?
I don't see why not, but...
Could be sick.
I'll ask Mandian what he thinks in the morning.
Ooh, yeah. I like Mandian Geldon, he's pretty good.
He's a smart boy. Always good to ask for his input on things.
You can say that again. With that, the evening draws pretty close, gentlemen. And if there's nothing else anyone wanted to do, you are all ready to enjoy the slumber in the luxurious bedding arrangements that is Red Face Jack's for the night.
Very nice. Very nice. Mandian will have to dismount his suit, but he will certainly enjoy that.
Okay, very good. Excellent. The night comes and goes with the arrival of the morning and everyone resting rather well. If anyone wants to spend any hit dice during the long rest, now is the time to do it. Or if not, then you may recuperate all of your spent hit dice and whatever, etc.
Very good. I will recover my whatever.
That's right. That's what you better do. Let's see. And we are on the next month, gentlemen. We finally made it.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Nice.
It's been a long time coming.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's now the month of Hearthfire. It's pretty neat.
Ooh.
Not so bad.
Not too bad.
Let's see. And you gentlemen arise in your respective rooms this morning. All being well. Eager nice. For another day of adventure and exploration. What do you think, gentlemen? What's the first order of business of the day?
Manning Gilda mounts the suit.
Makes sense to me.
Immediately.
Wolf's good heads down early for rations and to scout out the area.
Oh, very good. So be it. You head down rather early in the morning, it seems to you. Probably about 7-ish a.m. or so in the morning. And Red Face Jack is down there polishing the bar, greeting you. Welcome. It's like, how'd you sleep? Ooh, it's a good bone breaker.
Perfectly. And
about to hear it.
Osgood kind of just peers around. You said Red Face Jack himself is a rather large fellow, right?
He's a big dude. He's pretty serious.
Does he appear to be the biggest boy in the area?
Oh, he's big. He's definitely the biggest boy in the area. Right now, it's fucking empty in Red Face Jack's.
Okay. He doesn't have any, like, staff or anything?
It is no one except for you, Red Face Jax, some staff hands, and like two or three people in the dining area.
Okay.
Yeah, pretty desolate.
All right, and we're gonna just ask Red Face Jack, where can one go for some potions and perhaps maybe a spell scroll or two?
Potions, you say? Well, there might be something you could help me with, if you're willing, in exchange for the directions you seek.
Depends on what we're talking about.
I have a delivery that needs delivering.
If it's near to where I need to go, I don't see why not.
Fantastic.
Let's see. Sick. Red Face Jack pulls out a like pouch from beneath the counter and plops it right up on the counter. He's like,
take this up north to the shopping district.
And he winds out the shopping district for you, teaching you where the shopping district is.
Sick.
It's fucking huge. Let's see, where the fuck does he want to send you? He wants you to go to the potion shop.
So go, if you head all the way up to the northeast and there's a potion shop, pretty much hugging the perimeter wall, you can't miss it.
Alright. What am I delivering for you?
Oh, it's just some alchemical ingredients. Valuable stuff. Keep it low. Give it to Gamja.
Okay. Gamja. Okay.
Young Gamja, dude.
Gamja.
It's that Gamja.
Yeah, you should find him at his store, the Egg Essence. That's where you'll get all the potions you seek.
Sounds good, Jack.
Appreciate it.
Nice. And while I'm at it, I might as well show you guys the 6 points too. Because young James Wise Gamgee fucking told you boys about the 6 points.
Nice.
And it's red, so that means don't go there. Or you'll fucking die. Anyway.
I live there.
Don't fucking talk like that.
But I just bought property there.
Don't
Come on.
You talk like that. Anyway. Don't trigger me like that. Anyway, yeah. So there you go. A small side quest, potentially accepted for Red Face Jack. Delivery of some treats to young Gamja.
Gamja.
Down by the potion shop where Mandy and Geldon wants to flop. And
that's right.
Bonebreaker.
That's right.
Alright. Well, with that, gentlemen, fucking. What are you up to, Mandy and Geldon, now that you've finished mounting your suit?
Oh, I'm following down behind him, making sure Skeezwall can get down the stairs as well. And I'll be asking Red Face Jack if he has any, anything I can buy for breakfast. Any goodies?
Oh.
Do you do breakfast here, Redface?
Yeah, I can whip you up something good. Especially for a watchy. It's premium dining here until noon.
Premium. I'll
what
take
can
some
I get for you?
Something premium.
Excellent.
And he whips you up the house special.
Nice.
For a mere 2 gold pieces. He gets you a dank meal. Heavily discounted on account of you being a lodgie of the area.
Nice.
And it isn't open to the public until noon.
Interesting.
There's enough eateries and taverns and such around here that Redfish Jacks can afford to not open until noon.
Well, take advantage of the quiet breakfast time. Slurp it on down.
Yeah. It is nice. It is nice, you know. So it is a luxurious, you know, very warm, hearty interior. And yeah, I mean, you know, the private dining is nice.
Very good.
Really adds a bit to the luxurious aspect. Though it certainly cuts into his profit margin. He can clearly afford to do so. And is loving it. And he leaves you to your meal, which is scrumptious, some boiled eggs.
And very good.
Thinly sliced pork. As well as some mashed potatoes and spinach. It's fine. It's a delectable meal.
Very nice.
Delectable, hearty, and the portions are
yummy.
Ample. Uzku Bonebreaker, I assume you don't wait to watch Manion Gelden finish his breakfast.
Yes.
What are you up to?
So you said Mandian's having his breakfast?
He's having his breakfast, that's it. He will for at least a few more minutes yet.
I'll hang around and wait for him to be done.
Okay, alright, so be it. It is such. It is such. Mere 5 minutes or so later, Mandian Gelden is finished with his meal. Suited up and ready.
To Gamja.
Gamja. I suppose we can find Gamja. Where is he at?
There's a potion shop in the shopping district.
Potion shop. I'm there already. Let's do it.
Hey, Jack. Which way should we go to get there?
Just follow the main road up till you get to the town square. Then you can head up to the shopping district from there.
Ah, so right through the 6 points?
No, nope, don't do that.
All right, thanks. To the square first, boys.
Well, let's do it. And I will abruptly stand up and push my plate away.
Ah, very good. So be it.
You say fairly well, travelers. I'll see you again, I hope.
I give him a quick nod and say, well, hope we make it back in one piece. First day was already a disaster.
You gentlemen exit out into the main space once again along the main road. It isn't as tightly packed as it was yesterday. You guys seem to be early enough in the day that you're beating some of that noontime rush traffic.
Perfect.
So your speed will be a little bit more expedited as you move along the fine cobbled roads of Garza. Manion Gelden, give me a fucking perception check, you motherfucker.
Perception.
I want to see it with your eyes. I want to see it with your eyes.
Oof. I have a fucking...
Nothing.
Flash of genius.
Oh, shit. Damn.
Adding +4, making it 10.
Damn. You are just barely able to see the man that is, like, lashed to the... to the iron fence of the jail ward.
Ugh.
Like across the road. He watches like some of those like mean looking guardsmen like tie him up and then leave him there. And walk away and enter into one of the other buildings in the compound and just leave him like lashed up on the side of the fence. And you're like, oh shit, that's fucked up. And then you're like, wait, I know that guy. It's Merlin.
Poor Merlin, he probably deserves it. I don't know if I should get involved with that.
Yeah.
Those jail wardens seem pretty serious. And I will point it out to Uzgold and Skeezball and say, hey, look at him. We're almost there.
Don't talk like that, Mandian.
What, you want to go save him or something?
We best not get involved.
Skeezle Binbag ushers forth down the street.
That's what I thought. I'll keep trotting down the street.
Yeah, leaving Merlin to his fate for his crimes. The Crimson Bones leave him be. None of your business after all.
Sure, have a fair trial, it's fine.
none of your business after all. And you gentlemen head through, down along the main roads of Garza. Probably takes about a good half hour or so until you make it to the square. You know, it's fucking, you know, it's a good long while of walking, and every now and then you head down to, like, shuffling speed as you get, like, caught up in fucking traffic or whatever. You have to wait for, like, a caravan or, like, a Struthio Mimus fucking, you know, to fucking to clear out of the way. You can't escape the Struthio Mimus, as it seems, Mandy and Gelden. You take note that, like, you know, some Struthio Mimuses are used as, like, small caliber pack beasts and so on, you know. So you see someone every now and then riding a Struthio Mimus.
Take that, Struthio Mimus.
I keep an eye on Syphax in case he's having any PTSD moments.
Syphax does avert the Struthio Mimus. He is careful to avoid the Struthio Mimus at all times.
Very good.
It is true, you do notice. Anyway, you guys also make your way to the main square of Garza, and you take note of the rather fine, beautiful golden arch, you know, like dome-shaped roof that is the Temple of the Nine, a rather large, elaborate, you know, church-like structure. And a beautiful large square space that seems to be, you know, a massive, you know, gathering spot for the, you know, for the entire city. Seems like this is indeed the public square. And you hear criers, you know, shouting from almost like all corners of the Garza Square as morning news is being delivered. And if any of you guys care to listen, there's, you know, there's quite a few different tales being just shouted out to a few different crowds that have gathered around to listen.
I would definitely like to stop and listen for a second.
Okay, very good. There's you know, I will say there's a few different options. You take note of like three different criers that seem to have some decent crowds about them. You stop by the first one, and homeboy's bell went out, you know, pretty loud upon like this crate. Seems like an, older type of fellow, of some kind. The square, you know, fucking. It's an interesting scene, seeing all of these people gathered at like the foot of this one individual who's a you know, who's spouting this rhetoric, and as you're tuning in on it, it's a bit more, I don't know, you recognize some of the jargon being said. Rejoice, fine frontier folk! Nay, those who say we are lesser than, for we have saved ourselves by being cut from the cancer of the Empire of Tamriel. And, you know, like, the people in the crowd are like, woo, you know, fucking, you know, talking big shit. The Imperial Simulacrum bared the fruits for horror and incompetence for all to see. Now the heirs of the Empire's legitimacy is brought into question. Can anyone be surprised when the fruit of such a tree is rotten? And everyone fucking like shouts and jeers, you know, except you're like, oh shit. You know, you get a good taste for that one. and you fucking, and you know, you fucking, you know, you move on. Yeah, that's a, you know, that's a, you know, it's an interesting one. You spot another crier over yonder, and then you hear, you know, the great barrier, this, the almighty mana shell, the finest guardians from evil, you know, et cetera, et cetera. You know, it's like a, say it's like some kind of pro barrier, you know, speech about pro, about the magic barrier.
And some then, propaganda spouter.
And there's a good amount of people that are forced around that one. And you see another one that has, you know, about an equal amount of people over there. And you see the same guy, and he's, you know, he's talking about like a very similar thing. He's like, you know, the great barrier, the almighty mana shell. Dear people, is it any greater to be under those whims rather than those which we once feared so terribly? And like, this guy's giving like the, you know, the exact opposite speech. If you care enough to listen to that one. But this one is in opposition of the Dram Ward.
Oh, I love love listening to the Jews.
Who here remembers a time before that of the dread necromancer? Before the dark magic was even here, our fine city was a diamond of the island. Now we live in fear and squalor. The suffering's beyond belief. Give us the right to choose whether the barrier is for Garza is good or not. There you go. That's the gist. That's the gist. And people jeer and fucking
nods.
you know, and some people are in support of that for sure, you know. No doubt. Uzio Bonebreaker, how about a perception check out of you, my sweet prince?
I'll go passive.
Again?
15.
So be it.
Yeah.
So be it. A fine 15. You're able to make out a smaller voice trying to speak up from amongst the crowd.
I will look for it.
It catches your ears and your interest as you start honing in toward it. And you hear it a bit closer. All rivers of joy flow to the egg essence. Come now, potions for all. And you're like, where's that coming from? As you're like pushing across the sea of people, Manny Gelden in pursuit,
like Cecil
Binbag, and Syphax not far behind. Syphax like, oh, potions, that could be it. And then you get closer, who's a Bonebreaker, before you finally part enough people, and are able to see this small, green Argonian, who's kind of like looking upward, but even though he's standing on like a small stand of boxes, it's like, ah, come down to the egg essence for all your liquid needs.
The egg essence. I guess that's where we're going, right, guys?
Is it true?
Wait, was that the potion shop?
Come on, Mandy Gelden. Help out Uzu Bonebreaker, Mandy Gelden.
I wasn't there for the discussion. I don't know. I was upstairs in my room at the time. But I definitely agree we should go there and check it out.
You can do a history check, Uzu Bonebreaker, if you don't recall.
Yeah, I'm having trouble recalling. I don't even remember if he gave a name. I just know he said it was on the outer...
Damn.
Like, yeah, on the wall in the shopping district.
Damn, sounds like it's history check time. Damn, yep, that was it. That was it. That was it.
Okay, yeah, that's where we're heading, boys.
Let's head there Immediately then. No time to waste.
Damn. Damn, do you boys approach this small green boy?
Yeah.
Oh shit. Scott, come to
little
the
Argonian. I need potions.
What? You've come to the right place. Scary man. Bag essence will serve all your needs.
Well, come and lead us there then.
We'll
or
go on.
Customers.
Yes, sir. And he kind of like hops down from his, you know, his small little crate stoop thing he's made. And he kind of like,
mush.
and he like leads you guys down this down one of these narrow, kind of like what some would perhaps refer to as like snickle ways that you know these very you know very you know rather claustrophobic and sometimes almost like single file pathways that make up the heart of Garza. You know, it's very much, you know, it is the vast majority of the way people get around is through these maze like corridors and so on, and he leads you guys for a good while. At least 200 feet down or something. He's like, don't worry, my father will see to your every needs. You know, the small green Argonian says, leading you guys ever over yonder. Until eventually you get to a point pretty deep in, to like these snickle ways and so on, that it slowly begins to start opening up again, and the kind of like landscape of the area changes. You start seeing more like fenced in properties and so on and so forth, and more guard patrols. So Skis Open Bag would definitely notice and point out to you guys that you spot a good amount of guards down over this way. And the small Argonian is quick to take you guys down over yonder, deeper in still. Probably following this guy for like a half hour or so. And I was like, yes, almost there. Have no fear, excellent customers. And you know, the small Argonian kind of brings you guys over into a courtyard. And that, Manny and Gelden, is when your ears perk up as you hear a sound that you have not heard since you've been here last, or, you know, well, rather, since you've been here to begin with. Let's see, and that is the sound of an anvil being struck by a hammer, and you look over yonder to find what appears to be a small blacksmith, installation of some kind over yonder, and you
very nice
would most certainly take note of it as the small Argonian continues leading you. And Syphax's like, oh, come on, man, don't fall behind. and you are unfortunately pulled from the luster of, you know, this metallurgy station. And the young Argonian eventually brings you guys all the way over to like the corner of, you know, the city, basically, to this big, you know, this big, tall, towering, tapering, you know, building that has this small stained spiral window and a nice big wooden sign that has a, you know, like a mug with all types of, you know, little fuzzy magical aura depicted, you know, arriving out of it, and it says on it, the egg's essence.
Hey, the bear is still with us, correct?
No, the bear is gone, unfortunately. The bear disappeared.
Oh, it's gone now?
The bear disappeared. When you woke up, it was gone.
Darn
that,
it.
That is the truth.
I was hoping we had 24 hours with it.
The bear, unfortunately.
Fuck, I had a whole scheme brewing and everything. Never mind.
Sorry, it's a bone breaker. I'm sorry. Sorry, the bear. Bear is gone. Fucking bear.
That's the way it goes.
Hey. You do what you can. All right. So, with no bears being involved in this scenario, the young Argonian brings you guys over to like this large wooden door. Yes, just within here. And he knocks in a certain sequence, and then slowly opens up the door. To the warm, lit, dark interior. Yes, this way. Any slells within the darkness.
Manny and Gelden keeps his hand on his palm pistol while he enters.
Ready to shoot this child. at the slightest discrepancy.
That's right. I'm wary.
Do you two enter in, who's good Bonebreaker?
Guilt spray wet?
Yes.
Okay, so be it. The Crimson Bones entering into this dark interior of a supposed potion shop, following behind this juvenile wizard boy. And we'll find out what happens on the next episode, bitch.
Ooh,
damn.
That's what I'm talking about.
Dude, so lucky that bear's not around.
Oh, everyone's lucky, especially me.
I'm probably lucky.
That's sick, though. Oof. The bear moved.
Yeah. It was pretty sick. It was.